Good afternoon, children. Today we'll deal with this one, formula on inverse trigonometric functions, which is part first part. I will deal another part to complete this one. So to begin with, we have certain things to say first. How to find a formula or how to prove a formula on inverse trigonometric functions. So since it is the first part, first we'll deal with the thing which is your first set of formula. I have discussed it yesterday also regarding this. This is sine inverse, tan inverse and cosec inverse. When I write negative of that, so if I write negative of any angle of this one, then the answer becomes simply minus sine inverse x. This one will become minus tan inverse x, and this will become minus cosec inverse x. Now, number 2, if I have another set of functions, cos inverse minus x or cot inverse minus x or sec inverse minus x, in this case it will be nothing but pi minus cos inverse x. This will be also pi minus cot inverse x, and this will also become pi minus sec inverse x. Let me prove the first result. One of them I will prove. Suppose I want to prove sine inverse minus x, it is equal to minus sine inverse x. So I will let here x equals to sine x, sine theta suppose. Now let us see what is LHS. Our LHS is sine inverse minus of sine theta, because minus in place of x I will write minus of sine theta. So sine inverse, can I write this one as sine of minus theta? Because minus of sine theta, it is nothing but sine of minus theta. Now sine inverse and sine, they are together, I am left with only minus theta. Now this one, let us see the RHS. In RHS, this is negative sine inverse x, which is negative. In place of sine inverse x, you look at this expression, x is sine theta. So can I write theta is nothing but sine inverse x? So here minus sine inverse x can be written as negative of theta. So can you see LHS equal to RHS? So hence this part is proved. In number 2, I will prove any one of them. Suppose first one let us take up, cos inverse minus x. I have to prove it is pi minus cos inverse x. So here I will let x equals to cos theta suppose. So I will have LHS, this is nothing but cos inverse minus of cos theta, which is equal to cos inverse minus cos theta occurs in the second quadrant. So in this case I can write this is nothing but pi, that is cos of, in place of minus cos theta I will write cos of pi minus theta. Again cos inverse and cos are getting together, so I will write them as pi minus theta. Similarly, let us talk about RHS. RHS is pi minus cos inverse x, pi. Since I have taken x equals to cos theta, I can write cos inverse x is theta. Now you can clearly see LHS equal to RHS. So this part is proved. So this is my first set of formula. This is for negative angles. So try to have a look once again, and we'll proceed for the next one. Next, our next set of formula is, this is number 3, sum of the angles, that is sine inverse x plus sine inverse y. Second one I will tell you about cos inverse x plus cos inverse y, and third one I will tell about tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. This formula is sine inverse x into under root of 1 minus y square plus y into under root of 1 minus x square. Now if I have this one, then it is cos inverse, this is xy, minus under root of 1 minus x square into 1 minus y square. Similarly, this is nothing but, most important one, tan inverse x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. So let me prove the first one. Suppose I need to prove sine inverse x plus sine inverse y. It is equal to sine inverse x into square root of 1 minus y square plus y into square root of 1 minus x square. So here I let x equals to sine theta and y equals to sine beta, let us say. Let us make it alpha. X equals to sine alpha and y equals to sine beta. Now let us start from LHS. LHS is nothing but sine inverse x plus sine inverse y, which is equal to sine inverse in place of x. I can write it is sine alpha plus sine inverse in place of y. I can write simply this is sine beta. Sine inverse sine alpha will give you alpha and this will give you beta. So this is about LHS. Now let me talk about RHS. Your RHS is nothing but sine inverse x into 1 minus y square plus y into under root of 1 minus x square. So in this case, sine inverse in place of x, I write sine alpha into 1 minus this one will be cos square beta plus y, that is cos beta whole into square root of 1 minus this is sine square alpha. Now this is nothing but sine inverse, this is sine alpha multiplied by cos beta plus cos beta multiplied by sine alpha. So this is nothing but sine inverse sine alpha plus beta. This is the formula sine alpha cos beta plus cos beta sine alpha. This is the formula for alpha plus beta. So sine inverse sine alpha plus beta. This will give you nothing but alpha plus beta. Now this is the value of RHS and this is the value of LHS. So you can clearly see that LHS equal to RHS. So similarly, the remaining three formula or two formula can be proved. So let us have a look at these three formula once again. Here I have sine inverse x plus sine inverse y. It is equal to sine inverse x into 1 minus y square plus y into 1 minus x square, and cos inverse x plus cos inverse y, it is equal to cos inverse xy minus square root of 1 minus x square into 1 minus y square. Similarly, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, it is nothing but tan inverse x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. So now let us proceed to the next topic, which is very important for this chapter, and this topic is called interconversion between various trigonometric functions. So very important one. If you understand this one, then you will face never ever any problem in this topic. So our topic is interconversion of inverse trigonometric function. Now before that, let me take a triangle before you. Right triangle, suppose this is B, this is P and this is H, and I consider this one as theta. In this triangle I can write sin theta, it is P by H, cos theta, it is equal to B by H, tan theta, it is equal to P by B. Similarly, cot theta, it is equal to B by P, sec theta, it is equal to H by B, and cosec theta, it is nothing but H by P. So from all this, I can write here theta, it is nothing but sine inverse P by H. Look at this, sine theta is P by H, so your theta will be sine inverse P by H. Also in the second one you see, cos inverse B by H. Similarly in the third one, theta will be equal to tan inverse P by B. Look at the third one, here tan inverse P by B will be equal to theta. And in the fourth one, if I see, this is cot inverse B by P. Similarly in the fifth one, this is nothing but sec inverse H by B, and in the sixth one it is nothing but cosec inverse H by B. So therefore look at this, they all are equal to theta. Hence I will have to write This is nothing but sine inverse p by h. It is equal to cos inverse b by h. It is also equal to tan inverse p by b. It is equal to cot inverse b by p. And it is equal to sec inverse h by b, which is also equal to cosec inverse h by b. So now I will use this one to interconvert our various trigonometric functions, inverse trigonometric functions. So what is the use of this? Let me tell you. Suppose I will be asking one question: convert sine inverse 3 by 5 into cos inverse, right? So this is our question. What you do, first you take this one. This is sine is the ratio between p and h. Take this one as 3, this one as 5. So here from the left hand side I can write p equals to 3 and h equals to 5. Then you find b. B is nothing but under root of h square minus p square, which is equal to 4. Therefore sine inverse p by h, I am writing 3 by p 5, but it is actually p by h. It is equal to cos inverse, it should be b by h. Now in this case cos inverse, our b is 4 and h is 5. So sine inverse 3 by 5 is cos inverse 4 by 5. So here if you go to this one, suppose I ask you tan inverse p by tan inverse x, I want to convert it into cos inverse. How much, right? So let us solve this one. Tan inverse x, you just write it x by 1, then you draw a triangle. Tan is the ratio between p and b, so p is x and b is 1, so clearly it is the square of these two, that is 1 plus x square. So that is equal to cos inverse, this one should be b by h, and cos inverse b is 1 and h is under root of 1 plus x square. So in this method we can easily interconvert between various trigonometric functions. So now let us take up some of the questions directly. Suppose I will ask you, this is a question, prove that your sine inverse 8 by 17 plus cos inverse 4 by 5, it is equal to cot inverse 36 divided by 77. So let us take up this question. Now this is first to convert everything into tan, because tan is the easiest one to solve. Sin inverse 8 by 17, it is tan inverse, how much, let us find. For that you draw a triangle. Sin is the ratio between p and h, so here it is 8 and this is 17. So clearly if I take the square 64 and this is 289, so 17 square minus 8 square, so it is 17 plus 8 into 17 minus 8, so which is equal to 25 into 9. So if I take the square root, it is 5 into 3, which is 15. So now I have completed the Pythagorean triangle. First to complete it, then tan inverse, it is nothing but p by b, so it is equal to tan inverse 8 by 15. Now second one, you see this is cos inverse 4 by 5. Cos inverse, how much, let us see. For that you draw a triangle. I am targeting at tan inverse. I have to convert everything into tan inverse first, so it is equal to tan inverse p by b definitely. So let us complete the triangle. If I complete the triangle, cos is the ratio between b and h. So here if I take b as 4, h should be 5. If I complete the triangle, this is square of this minus square of this, which is will be equal to 3. So this will be nothing but tan inverse 3 by 4. So therefore, let us start LHS. Our LHS is sin inverse 8 by 17 plus cos inverse 4 by 5. Now I am already having, this is tan inverse 8 by 15 plus this one is tan inverse 3 by 4. This is nothing but tan inverse A plus tan inverse B. Let us see the formula. So I have already told you regarding this formula. Please see, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, it is nothing but tan inverse x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. So I am going to use it. So this part is nothing but tan inverse, this one will be x plus y, that is 8 by 15 plus 3 by 4 divided by 1 minus 8 by 15 into 3 by 4. So let us solve it, simplify it. Tan inverse 15 into 4, LCM is 60, this is 32 plus 45 divided by, here also LCM is 60, this is 60 minus 24. So if I calculate, this will be nothing, 60 60 getting cancelled, this is nothing but 77 divided by 36. Now let us see RHS. RHS is nothing but cot inverse 36 by 77. So it is very simple. If I draw this triangle, this will be 36 and this will be 77. I don't even need to find this one. Please see, this is nothing but tan inverse P by B. I am having P by B now. This is tan inverse P is 77 and this is 36. So look at LHS and RHS. So therefore LHS equal to RHS and my proof is completed. So please have a look at this proof once again. I will keep it for 2 seconds. This type of questions are very, very important from CBSE point of view. So now let us take up another question. The question goes like this, very, very important one. Prove that cos inverse 4 by 5 plus cos inverse 12 by 13, it is equal to cos inverse 33 divided by 65. So this can be solved directly by without interconversion. Cos inverse 4 by 5 plus cos inverse 12 by 13, it is equal to, let us check the formula once again, right? Here you see cos inverse x plus cos inverse y, it is nothing but cos inverse xy minus under root of 1 minus x square into 1 minus y square. So let us put it. If I put it now, this will be equal to nothing but cos inverse xy, that is 4 by 5 into 12 by 13. I am using this formula, cos inverse x plus cos inverse y, it is nothing but cos inverse xy plus under root 1 minus x square into under root 1 minus y square. So let us put it, plus under root 1 minus x square, that is 4 by 5 whole square into 1 minus, this is 12 by 13 whole square. So here cos inverse, if I have the LCM, or this is 12 4 is 48 and this is 13 5 is 65, plus this one is 3 by 5, and if I solve, this is 5 by 13. Again this is cos inverse. If I take the LCM 65, this is 48 plus 15. So if I find the answer at last, it will be cos inverse, this is 3 and this is also 48 plus, sorry, in the beginning I should have put minus here. The formula is not plus, the formula is minus. So if I solve this one, this will be 33 divided by 65. So this is how we prove certain questions. So you solve some of the questions from NCERT exercise.